chopper for now. Boss, you need to eliminate the skulls. You cannot lose Code Talker.
Code Talker.
word, boss. I'm coming in on another chopper. Get Code Talker to the LZ and wait there.
This is Pequod. Arriving shortly at LZ. This is Pequod. On station at LZ.
Get in, boss. All right, mission complete, boss. Maybe you'll actually break a sweat next time, huh?
Skullface is no longer in Africa. The nuclear test was a success. Now they turn the knives on me.
Satellites didn't read any test. Neither did seismometers.
The detonation test took place 5 years ago in the southern Indian Ocean. The final test was the opposite. To prevent detonation.
You mean?
Skullface plans to sell nuclear weapons that he retains control of.
It's not like hawking small arms to militias.
Plans to avoid detection. We're exporting minerals containing tiny amounts of uranium in the form of metallic archaea. Once on site, the metallic archaea enrich the uranium and weaponize it. Loaded onto all-terrain bipedal machines, they ensure any country, armed group, even the smallest terrorist cell can become a nuclear power.
Bipedal. So that's why they needed Huey.
A nuke business to replace the arms business. And Skullface owns the market.
The very atmosphere of nukes, anywhere and everywhere. Deterrence on all sides.
So that's why he ran a non-detonation test.
Yes. Another metallic archaea instantly overrides the criticality generator. A fail-safe only he controls. Any such weapon can be deactivated whenever he chooses, regardless of who owns it or their intent to use it.
Nukes. In controlled by a man, not a country.
If they proliferate, conventional nukes lose all value. Political, military, and economic. The two superpowers become powerless.
R&D and medical teams have come up with a proposal for a new suit that applies Code Talker's research, the Parasite Suit. Apparently, it can recreate some of the skull's unusual abilities, but in order to use those abilities, it needs parasites.